Hey guys, right here I have a 2014 Seat Leon 1.2 TSI SE. And today I'm gonna make a startup and full vehicle tour video of it, show you the features inside and out. So, here's the key. Let's go ahead and start it up first. If you press and hold on the unlock button, you're able to roll down all four windows simultaneously. And to roll them back up together, just press and hold on the lock button. This car only has 67 miles. And it does come with the 6-speed manual transmission. To start the car, put your foot on the clutch and simply twist the key. The Leon comes with an electric rack and pinion power steering system. Standard on the SE trim is a leather wrapped steering wheel with sport grips on the sides. The 1.2 TSI Leon gets two transmission options. A 6-speed manual as seen in this Leon is standard, while a 7-speed direct shift gearbox dual clutch automated manual transmission is optional. To engage reverse for this transmission, push the lever down and all the way to the left and up. Safety in the Leon SE consists of 7 airbags, anti-lock braking system with electronic brake force distribution and brake assist, electronic stability control, tire pressure monitoring system, electronic differential lock, hill hold control, alarm system, immobilizer, and ISOFIX child seat anchor points for the rear seats. Alright, let's now turn on the hazards, lights, front and rear fog lights, take a look at the engine, and roll down the driver's side window. The bonnet release is located to the left of the front passenger's footwell. The Leon SE comes as standard with 16-inch 10-spoke alloy rims. The rims on this car are wrapped in Dunlop Sport Blue Response 205-55R16 tires. The front gets ventilated disc brakes, while the rear gets solid disc brakes. The suspension comprises of McPherson struts in front and a torsion beam set up at the back. The Mark III Leon was launched in the UK during the first quarter of 2013. There were a number of engine choices available, and this generation also gets the most body styles available for a Leon so far. In addition to the Leon 5-door hatchback, there is also a 3-door Leon SC, an estate Leon ST, and a rugged all-road estate Leon ST experience. The full list of Leon 5-door variants available in the UK can be found in the description box below this video. Exterior features of the mid-range Leon SE includes halogen reflector headlights, halogen daytime running lights, LED side indicators, front and rear fog lights, cornering lights, and body-coloured bumpers, door handles, and side mirrors. The 1.2-litre engine in this Leon displaces 1,197 cubic centimetres, and it features an inline-4 layout with dual overhead cams, 16 valves, direct injection and turbocharging to produce 108 horsepower between 4600 and 5600 RPM and 175 Nm of torque between 1400 and 4000 RPM. 0 to 62 miles per hour or 0 to 100 kilometers per hour is achieved in 9.9 seconds on to a top speed of 121 miles per hour, which is about 195 kilometers per hour. With a tank carrying 50 litres of petrol, the Leon 1.2 TSI manages a combined fuel consumption of 57.6 miles per gallon or 4.9 litres per 100 kilometres. 114 grams of carbon dioxide is emitted per kilometre and the Leon is front-wheel drive. SEAT is an automobile brand from Spain. It was created in 1950 and the name is actually an acronym for Spanish Touring Car Company in Spanish. Over the years, it has developed its own cars, partnered with Fiat, and most recently in 1986, SEAT was taken over by the VW Group as part of its expansion plan with a 51% majority stake. By 1990, the VW Group became the new owners of SEAT. The Leon was one of the later products to come out from SEAT under VW Group's ownership. The first generation Leon debuted in 1999 as the hatchback version of the Mark II SEAT Toledo. It was based on the PQ34 platform that also underpinned the Mark IV VW Golf, the Mark I Audi A3, and the Mark I Skoda Octavia. The Mark II Leon was released in 2005 as a replacement for the Mark I, and like its predecessor, the second generation Leon, now based on the PQ35 platform, was also related to other VW Group products, but this time the Mark V and Mark VI VW Golf and the Mark II versions of both the Audi A3 and Skoda Octavia. The third and current generation Leon was launched back in 2012 and it is based on the latest MQB platform that is also used by the Mark 7 VW Golf and the Mark 3 versions of both the Audi A3 and Skoda Octavia. Right down here, you do have your speaker, some storage, window controls, all of them are automatic, window lock, mirror controls, and your central locking. Right next to the headlight switch, you do have the lever to adjust the level of your headlight. And right down here, you do have some storage. The driver's seat in this Leon comes with full manual adjustments. This one controls your lumbar, this one controls your seat back, This one controls your seat height. And this one controls your seat position. You also do have some under seat storage for the driver's side only. Alright, so let's go ahead and see how she revs. This Leon does come standard with air conditioning. All your controls are located right here. It is quite simple to use. You do have your fan speed in the middle, different modes to the right with your front defrost, your temperature to the left, air conditioning, rear defrost, and your recirculation. Right up here, you do have the button to turn off your auto start stop system. And this Leon also comes standard with a 5-inch touchscreen head unit with various media connectivity options and 6 speakers. I must say, it does have quite a nice sound system. There's enough bass response and the quality is not too bad for a stock system. This is your main FM screen. There are 4 quadrants as well as 2 options for your submenu, top and bottom. On the top left, you do have your different customizable stations. There are 12 of them, each for FM and AM. Top right, list of available stations in your area. Bottom right, your manual tuning. You can use the plus and minus arrows on the screen to tune to your desired radio stations, or you can use the knob right here. Once you tune to your desired radio stations, you can save in the customizable stations slot. And you do have your traffic information down below. If you hit setup, brings up your FM setup. If you do not want to use the touchscreen to scroll through your different options, you can use the knob. And if you hit menu, it goes back to your main menu. In media, if you do have any media connected, you will have choice of either CD, auxiliary, USB, Bluetooth audio streaming, SD card, along with your regular FM and AM. If you do have a USB connected, let's say, you will have this selection button right here illuminated. You can click on it and it will bring up your list of songs on the USB drive. Or if you have a CD connected, you can look through the playlist on the CD. The bottom left and right switches between your different folders, and again you do have your media setup. Next up, we do have sound. In sound, this is your balance and fader. Equalizer brings up your bass, middle and treble. Your media information, whether it's radio or USB or whatnot. Mute. Bottom right resets to your original settings, and again your setup. Hit menu again to go back to your main menu once more. Next up, we do have car. This is your driving data. There are three sets of it: since start, long term, and the since the last refuel. The driving data includes your distance traveled, elapsed time, average speed, and average fuel consumption. You also do have your range, time, and outside temperature. Eco mode for your eco driving, and your tire pressure monitoring system. Again, your setup. You can turn off your electronic stability control and anti-skid regulation, tires, your lights, mirrors and wipers, opening and closing, your service indicator, what menus you want to be displayed on the multifunction display, your time and date, units and all that. You can also reset it back to factory settings. Setup, you can turn the display off. The screen setup, sound, language, time and date, units again, and your Bluetooth setup. Turn it on or off. Find your paired devices. Turn on the Bluetooth audio streaming and all that. You also have system information and copyright information. And lastly, your Bluetooth telephone menu. In this menu, you can pair a phone, delete a phone, look through your contacts, dial a number, look at your received your last received calls and all that. You can turn on the Bluetooth using this menu as well. Right up here, you do have your CD player. It is MP3 compatible. Your mute button, eject, and on the left and right sides of the screen, you basically have what is shown right here: radio, media, sound, phone, car, and menu. And right down here, your SD card slot. Electronic central locking. On the steering wheel, the left spoke houses your on-hook off-hook button, your switching between your different tracks or radio stations buttons, and this scroll wheel that either mutes the system or changes the volume. On the right spoke, the left, right, and this scroll wheel right here that goes scrolls up, scrolls down, and clicks down for enter controls your multi-information display in the instrument cluster. Right now you do have average consumption, range, elapsed time, distance travel, average speed, your digital speedometer, oil temperature, coolant temperature, your instant fuel consumption, and back to your average fuel consumption. Also, if you notice, down there, it does say since start. If you click down on the scroll wheel, you can also scroll through between your since start,
your long-term data, or your since the last refuel data. If you use the left and right arrows, go through between your different menus, you also do have audio. In audio, you can select your different tracks, radio stations, and all that. Your Bluetooth telephone menu, and your vehicle status. The stalk on the right controls your wipers, and the stalk on the left controls your indicators, as well as cruise control. The steering wheel in this car is tilt and telescopic. You adjust it using this lever right here. Right down here, you do have some storage. Cup holders. Power outlet down here. As well as some storage right here with an adjustable center armrest. Manual dimming, rear view mirror. And right up here, you do have your interior lights. Turning on the interior lights right here also turns on the one at the back. You do have a sun visor with a vanity mirror and a light. Alright, so I guess that's it for the startup. We can turn it off right now and continue with the rest of the tour. You do have some storage right here with your speaker and window control. Rear seats do fold. Just locate this lever, pull on it, and the seat back folds down. The driver's seat is actually in a position that I would be comfortable in while driving, and at the back I have this much leg room and about 4 centimeters of headroom, which is actually quite good. You do have storage pockets on the front seat backs, rear aircon vents, handles right up here, as well as your hooks on the B pillar. As shown, your interior lights, it's a dial, so this is in your off position. Turning on the left light, turning on the position where the lights would turn on when the doors are opened, your right light, and just simply turning on the light. No rear center armrest for this one. open up the rear hatch, just locate the SEAT badge at the back and simply push it in and pull the rear hatch up.
Boot space in the Mark III Leon is identical to the Mark VII Golf at 380 litres with the rear seat bags in place. Folding the Leon's rear seat bags down and removing the cargo cover increases the boot space to 1,210 litres. There is a light to the right of the boot that illuminates the area, and underneath the boot floor is a bit of storage and the vehicle's tyre repair kit. You do have adjustable headrests, front and rear. And you do have your speaker down there with your storage area and your window control. The front passenger seat in this car does get full manual adjustments as well. It just loses out on the lumbar support as found on the driver's side.
You do have quite a big glove box. It is two-tier, you have one tier down here and another one right up here. You also do have your auxiliary and USB ports right in here. And you do have the sun visor with a vanity mirror and a light on this side as well. Alright, so let's start it up with the door closed. Alright, so that's it for the startup and full vehicle tour video of this 2014 SEAT Leon 1.2 TSI SE. Thanks for watching and goodbye.